الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد أيها الأحبة أيها الأحباب We ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His divine names and attributes by all His divine names and attributes that He protects us from every kind of harm and every kind of innovation and anything that will cause us to be led astray. And this is why the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam during the khutbah al-hajjah always or taught his sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in how to be thankful to Allah and ask for His guidance and to beware those things which would deter them from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by causing deviation and innovation in the religion. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, فَإِنَّ الْأَسْدِكَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَخَيْرًا هَدِي هَدِي مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا وَكُلُّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ وَكُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ وَكُلُّ ضَلَالَةٍ وَأَهْلِهَا فِي النَّارِ أو وَكُلُّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ وكما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم in the many variations the various narrations of that hadith. But ayyuha al-ahbab, some of the main points worth mentioning, because we hear it every Jumu'ah. Even Ahlul Bid'ah says that. Even the people of innovation and desires, they say the same khutbah al-hajjah. And ayyuha al-ahbab, it's important for us to reflect on the meaning. فَإِنَ الْأَسْدِكَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ The best speech, the perfect speech, divine speech, is that which was revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Qur'an is that which we have left to implement in our lives and to practice and understand Islam and to gain the rulings of the Sharia. فَإِنَ الْأَسْدِكَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ That's the most truthful speech. The most truthful speech is the speech of Allah. It's unflawed, uncreated. The Qur'an is not created. The Kalam of Allah is not created. This is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's one of His attributes. وَإِنَ الْخَيْرَ هَدِي فَإِنَ الْخَيْرَ هَدِي هَدِي مُحَمَّدٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم And the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet. So when we want to know how to have the best manners, when we want to know how to exhibit brotherhood, when we want to know how to build a community, when we want to know what creed and aqidah we should have, when we want to know what methodology and manhaj we should have for da'wah, فَنَا أَسْتِكَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابَ اللَّهُ وَخَيْرًا هَدِي هَدِي مُحَمَّدٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم The best guidance is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم's guidance. It's what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called to. عليه الصلاة والسلام. So that's the best minhaj, the best methodology, and the best guidance in all of our affairs. The dunya wal akhirah. It will help us in this life as well as the hereafter. Ayyuha al-ahbab. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, after saying, فَإِنَ الْخَيْرَ هَدِي هَدِي مُحَمَّدٍ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا And the worst of affairs is that which is innovated. You know, newly innovated matter. That doesn't mean, ayyul ahbab, inventions and things that we benefit in our lives. No, that's not what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was talking about. That is in reference to bid'ah lughawi, you know, innovation regarding being innovative in technology and innovative in architecture and innovative in all the other, in the sciences and so forth. There's nothing wrong with that as long as it does not contradict and is not as harmful knowledge. But Ayyu al-Ahbab, the Prophet ﷺ was warning against innovating in the religion, meaning in worship and all the aspects which are already known from the religion, which come in the Quran, which were revealed in the Quran, the speech of Allah, and were illustrated by the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. To come up with something new after that, a new form of guidance, is very dangerous. And in fact, depending on what you believe about that newly invented form of political orientation or that newly religious practice and so forth, they can take you out of the fold of Islam as well. Ayyu al-Ahbab. So, khayran hadi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It's not the guidance of Sheikh so-and-so, or Imam so-and-so, or Pope so-and-so, President so-and-so, Leader so-and-so. But the best guidance is that of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That which conforms to the shara'. That which is based on the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Because the Sunnah explains the Quran. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his life, he was a living example of the Quran. So if you want to know about manners, you want to know about anything, about belief, about system of governance, everything is from the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs is that which is newly invented, meaning related to the religion. شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة. And every newly innovated matter is a bid'ah. So this is something madhmum, something sinful. It is an innovation. And every innovation leads to misguidance. And of course, misguidance, Ayyu al-Ahbab, is the opposite of guidance. That means you're being taken away from something. If I'm misguided on this trail, that means I've been led to go away from the main trail, the main path. Likewise, the individual who misguides, or the one who is misguided, is the one who has deviated from the religion. They've deviated from the straight path. They've deviated from Siratullah al-Mustaqim, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Inna hadhi siratu mustaqim fa'tabi'u wa la ta'tabi'u subul." Verily, this is my straight path. So follow it, and do not follow those other paths, meaning those innovated paths, those paths that have a shaitan on the end of them calling to other than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, and calling to other than what the sunnah, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was revealed to illustrate. وَعِيَاذٍ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. May Allah protect us from kufr, shirk, nifaq, and bid'ah, and those things which He hates, and bless us with those things which He loves. Because everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves is ibadah. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates is that which we should stay away from, is haram, prohibited. And we ask that Allah the Almighty accepts our good and forgives our evil and protects us from everything which He is displeased with. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.